Hello, my name is Tim van der Vliet. I am doing a video about the fact that I'm doing 6 years plus of Wim Hof method. And I met Wim 6 years ago, and it was really funny. I went to his workshop, and we spoke for a bit, but we didn't really connect on a deeper level. And we were doing breathing techniques. It was very chaotic. We even did the forbidden technique that makes you pass out. So people were passing out, you know, like one by one, me too. And this was my first time ice bath. And I will tell you a bit more about my past later, but I had been doing some yoga, I was working on my personal development, whatever. And I wanted to be, out of 50 people, I wanted to be the first one in the ice bath, you know, to get it over with. So I was like number 3 or something. I went in the ice bath. I had no guidance from Wim. He just said, right on. And I tensed every muscle of my body. And I stayed in for a full amount of 10 seconds. That was my first ice bath. Everybody in my courses, I'm a Wim Hof method instructor, everybody in my courses is always better than I was the first time, right? So this is the first time that I met Wim. And then 5 years ago, we both had to do a talk in Brighton in the UK. And this is where we had a full day together, and we walked on the beach and we talked about everything, and we became like friends, or intuitive brothers, or heart brothers, whatever you want to call it. We ended up in a gay bar drinking a beer, and my summary of the whole, you know, 6 hour talk that we had was, man, you're really a brother from another mother, touching my heart, but the same mother planet. And Wim said, yeah, still fucked up, but aware this time. Anyway, since 6 years ago, I've been doing cold training and breathing techniques every day. And let me tell you a little bit about my past before. I'm a stock market boy. I've been working as a trader in the option and stock exchange. And in 2003, what is it, 18 years ago, in 6 months' time, I lost all my money. You know, riding my bicycle to work, not spending anything, and spending 100,000 euros per month on losing money. Every day, 3,000 euros. It was hell. You know, and in hindsight, this was where I started to grow mentally. So I got another job in the financial world, in a Swiss algorithm trading company, working together with people, mathematics and artificial intelligence. I learned a lot about science there. And the last 2 years, I call it my open up phase. I worked full time. I had 3 kids back then, and 5 now. And I partied like 1 or 2 evenings, nights per week. And at night, the other nights, I was studying. I read every self-help book. I, you know, watched YouTube films. I slept for 2 years, like 3 hours a night. And not because I was worried, but because I was, how do you say, switched on, you know, like I had so much energy. And this ended up, I journaled, I wrote down my thoughts, and this ended up in this book here that was published by an English publisher, sorry for that, an English publisher called Hay House. And that is where I started teaching. Now, I was doing yoga every day and I was feeling very developed, but you know, in hindsight, I understood the whole concept of spiritual development or personal development, but I wasn't living it yet. So, and this started after I started doing the Wim Hof method. And like, if you cut down a lot of blah blah from the Wim Hof method, one of them, you know, there's the 3 pillars, you know, mindset and cold training and breathing techniques. But one of the main things, the main messages is that if you engage in a controllable way with light hormetic stress, you get to be calmer. This is a kind of paradox. Now, since 6 years ago, my cold training, I'm training light. I'm doing exercises every day. I will get back to it because I'm doing more than the Wim Hof method. And what I'm doing is not the three pillars, mindset, breathing and cold training, but three more. So I'm doing every day light exercises, the five Tibetan rites to be precise. I'm doing a few rounds of breathing. And I'm ending my shower cold between 1 and 3 minutes, depending on how much energy I need for the day. Now, I was actually doubting to make this video today because last night I have a baby, little Zoe, 1 year old, and there was something wrong with him. And I was alone with him, so nobody else could take care of him. And he woke up every half hour. You know, aside from that, the weather is bad and it's very windy, and that has an effect on my mood and on my hair too, by the way. It explodes, you know? You know, like JC, the gangster rapper, he sings, I look in the mirror, my only opponent. When I look in the mirror, what I see is hair. And based on my hair, the way my hair is, I can see my mood, the weather outside, like all this stuff. You know, but to cut the joke, I'm not feeling 100% now. Because I almost didn't sleep and it's windy outside, and I'm not windy, the weather is windy, it's windy outside and I don't feel optimal. But having said that, you know, compared to when I started like 15 years ago, my 100% is 3 times bigger than the 100% 15 years ago. So even though I have a crappy day, I thought like, you know, what the hell, you know, why not make the video? You know, show me the way I am, also when I have a bad day, basically. So this is one of the main things I learned from meeting Wim, practicing the method, is that I went out of stress and pain, we'll get back to that, into being able to put a lot more on my to-do list without becoming overstressed. Yeah, so 6 years ago, I was doing yoga already daily basis for like, say 7 years or something. But still, my left leg was full of pain. I had a thing in my heel spore. I had a meniscus in my left knee. And my left butt had like a sore muscle, but continuously. And now looking back to, you know, like preparing for this video, like what has actually changed? Aside from I can put so much more on my to-do list and staying calm, I'm completely pain-free now. And the third thing is that what I understood 13 years ago when I wrote and published this book, Have Fun, it says, is that then I understood it, and now I'm in the process of living it. I don't want to claim I'm anywhere because there is a lot of growth still to do. And I believe this is, you know, you have to enjoy the process. There's no goal. There's no goal. There's just the path, the process. Ooh, Tim is getting woo woo. Okay, so let me explain what my 6 pillars are. Yeah, so mindset training, cold training, and breathing techniques. That's the Wim Hof method. My pillars are cold training. Every day ending my shower cold whenever I can. I take an ice bath or cryo whenever it's offered to me for free, basically. Then breathing techniques. I learned a lot more breathing techniques than the Wim Hof method. So these days, and this is a very positive thing of my life, I made my job out of not only being a Wim Hof method instructor, but also being a breathing expert. And I really help people, you know, people that are near the ground and have trouble with whatever, an autoimmune illness or depression or stuff like that, people with a burnout, but also people that are already performing highly, like CEO types. I'm giving a lot of corporate sessions. Let me know if you want to do a corporate session for your company. So, breathing techniques, cold training, pillar 1 and 2. I will get back to the mindset. Pillar three for me is nutrition. Very simple, simply said. What goes in must come out. Now, I live very healthy, though I'm not rigid when it comes to retoxing. Yeah, you know, eating healthy, detoxing. The opposite, putting dirt in your body, is retoxing. This is a kind of a paradox, what I'm going to say now, but if we focus too much on only being healthy, 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 we get to live a little bit more in our mind. And if we like retox once in a while, whatever it is, it can be meat or fish or alcohol or sugar or carbs or whatever your retox is. But putting a bit of dirt in your body is also like light hermetic stress, and your body has something to process. It makes you more resilient. So what I claim is, I don't claim that you should retox, don't get me wrong, but if you do, that you shouldn't worry about it, because it may actually be healthy, you know? There's this research about this called the hygiene hypothesis. It's about children that grow up in a large household with dogs, with a lot of other children, and children that go to daycare. And they're exposed to many, much more bacteria and viruses. And at a later stadium in their life, they have less chance of allergies. So this proposes that too clean may not be so healthy. And I'm very connected to Japan. And very inspired also nutrition-wise by the Japanese. Vary your food, you know, eat a lot of different things. And they're not like, they drink more, they smoke more. Still, they become on average 5 years older than the average American or European. I believe this is because they vary food. But the Japanese smoke more and they drink more alcohol and still they become older. Why is that? Well, what I understand is because they vary their food. So that's one of the things that I do. And then looking at the detox, retox, no, I will get back to that when I get to the mindset training. Yeah, so nutrition is pillar number three, you could say. Then number four, exercise. Every morning before breakfast, preferably when you wake up, immediately after you wake up, do from 2 minutes when you start out, you're super overweight or you have an injury, to maximum 10 minutes a day. 10 minutes is top sport. If you get there, you will never ever have to go to the gym anymore. And in COVID times, you know, it lasts already about a year. My body hasn't changed. And I don't, you know, like, do any intense exercise. I used to go to hot yoga almost every day. Nothing of that now. I don't run. That is on my list to do more. And still, my body is the same. So this stuff really works. Yeah, so that's pillar number four, light exercise. And then my favorite exercise is always when you start out, the arm twist. It gives you energy. And because of that energy, you're dropping weight through the day. And then move to the five Tibetan rites. You can find them on my channel. I will put a link in the description as well. There's a whole playlist of the five Tibetan rites, actually. These are amazing exercises that, according to the legend, make your body younger, you know, and it stops your hair from being gray. Now, I'm 51, I'm not gray, although my beard is, funny enough. But I don't know if it's because of the exercise or because I'm just lucky, you know, like, I don't know. But if you don't do daily exercise yet, please start with it because it gives you amounts of energy. And then, you know, my next point, not pillar five, but my next point is form a daily routine. It's so important. So I do a minimum, that stuff that I have to do for myself. And I do a maximum, that what I would want to do or grow to. That maximum is always getting bigger, bigger. And my minimum morning ritual is at this moment, I'm teaching a lot of breathing. So I'm at this moment actually not doing the Wim Hof method in the morning. I'm doing seven repetitions of the five Tibetan rites. Then I do 5 rounds of Tuma breathing, and then a minute of meditation, breathing slowly. And then when I shower, or if I shower, some days, you know, COVID, when I shower, I end my shower cold for 1 to 3 minutes, minimum 1 minute. My maximum daily ritual is at this moment 21 times repetitions of the 5 Tibetan rites, 21 push-ups, 21 ab rolls, and then 20 minutes of running or trampoline jumping every day. 4 rounds of Wim Hof method breathing, and ending my shower cold 2 to 5 minutes. Yeah, and I move somewhere in between, but if I've done my minimum, that's actually good enough. You know, I'm very busy these days, so that's the way I work, basically. Okay, let's go into my pillar number 5. Mindset training, but a bit different from the Wim Hof method. The Wim Hof method, it really connects also. The Wim Hof method, mindset training, you can summarize into 2 sentences. One is, you can do more than you think you can, which is a paradox. Because if you think you can do more than you think you can, you already thought you could do more. You see what's happening? A paradox is a statement that is a logical statement that is both true and untrue. The second sentence for the Wim Hof method mindset is to become comfortable in an uncomfortable situation, which is another paradox. And uncomfortable situations, stress, by training daily deep breathing techniques, hormetic stress, ending your shower cold, hormetic stress, but light and controllable. You can get out of the shower anytime. You can stop breathing anytime. And if you stop breathing, it would all go away. Right? I'm so bad in making jokes with myself. And then, sorry for having to watch this, you know. Now, what is the paradox? The power of paradox, I call it. And I'm writing a book at this moment, and it's still not finished for the people that are waiting for it, you know, but I am working on it. So a paradox is a statement that is true and untrue at the same time. Now, our minds cannot handle a paradox because our minds, rational minds, have to put something in a box, either left or right, up, down, whatever, male, female, you know, like good looking, bad looking. We just do that. That's the way our mind is wired. There's nothing wrong about that, but that's just the way it works. So what happens if we hear a paradox that is put in the true and untrue box at the same time? Our minds get confused. Now, if in the analogy of the rational mind being a computer program, the mind gets confused, the computer program crashes, and what is left? Everything else but your rational mind. You can call it intuition or hard thinking or gut feeling, whatever you want to call it. And those centers are beneficial when we make decisions from our not rational mind. And then you can check with your rational mind if that decision makes sense. This is like very shortly the power of paradox. When I finish my book and I put it on Amazon, you know, it's published, I will make a lot of videos. I will basically make all these little chunks from the book and put everything in videos, you know. So if you keep on following my channel, you will not have to buy the book. But of course, buying the book is greatly appreciated. So that was pillar number 5, mindset training through the power of paradox. Know you know nothing is another paradox. I like to call myself the know nothing teacher, because I'm always curious to learn. And if you think you know it all, you get cocky and you screw up for sure. You know, you get arrogant. That's like the old school teacher, the 2.0 teacher, what I feel, what I try to live, actually live. is know you know nothing, stay curious like a child. So you keep on learning, be a forever student. The best teacher is a forever student. It's another paradox. When you find a paradox on your path, you're probably on the right path. All right, mindset training through the power of paradox. And then number six is meditation. Now, when I published this book, I became a meditation teacher. And as I just said, you know, I understood all the concepts, but I wasn't living it. I was meditating 1-2 hours a day. But in hindsight, you know, I was on the path, but I was also not always that nice, especially to the people I love, like my wife and my mother, for example. You know, mom, Mio, if you're watching this, I'm sorry. And now, because I put myself under this light hermetic stress daily, aside from all the benefits of the breathing technique, of the Wim Hof method breathing technique and cold training, it's like I opened up more. And now, compared to 10 years ago, I do spontaneous meditations. After every breathing session, I slow down my breathing. What is the big how to meditate? Slow down your breathing. And if I sit for 10 minutes, I get within a few minutes in such a deeper state compared to 10 years ago when I was a meditation teacher. It's just a big, big difference. And I think we came to the end of this video. I've talked too much. This is a long video. Thank you for watching it all the way to the end. And I will put down some things on paper. If you want to download that PDF, it's in the description of this video. And the things I will make, like another video about more deeper about the nutrition and stuff like that. But the things that I mentioned will be in the description of this video. And if you want to know more about, you know, like I call it TT, Tim's Techniques, the six pillars of Tim's Techniques, download that PDF in the description. And that was it. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want, also very much appreciated, subscribe to my channel. And if you really want to be annoyed every time I post a video, you can hit that notification bell. Then you get an email whenever I post a video. Okay, these were my lessons of meeting Wim. Amazing guy, Wim, thank you. You're a big teacher for me. And 6 years of practicing the Wim Hof method plus. See you later in the next or in a previous video. Bye bye.